Alright, and welcome back. So in this video, what we're going to talk about is exactly how you quickly can get creators working with your agency. Again, regardless of if you have case studies, regardless of if you worked with other models, other creators, you can easily, by following this video, get some creators that are one interested and end up closing in terms of working with your agent. So I'll quickly go through a couple pointers that you can follow. Again, very simple to implement, and then you can go ahead in the next 1 or 2 weeks start to get people interested in your services as an OnlyFans agency and get creators working with your agency. All right, so the reason you aren't currently getting responses with the outreach is basically no trust. This means that whoever's on the other side of the message that you're sending out just doesn't trust that you can deliver on what you're saying that you can, or you are positioning yourself as an agency, but they don't trust that you can actually get them the results that you're claiming. So if the creator you reach out to trust that, one, you're who you say you are, two, you're someone capable of getting them results, they will respond to your message. It's literally as simple as that. So again, reverse engineering, if you don't have the responses that you want, most likely it's because they don't trust who you are and they don't trust you're capable of getting them results. So quickly, what are the 3 ways to build more trust when doing outreach? Solve these things and you're going to get much more responses back. You're going to get much more meetings booked with creators and you're going to get many creators on board with your agency. So the first thing is building more trust with social proof. So this is likes. For example, if you're using an Instagram page, the more likes your page has, that is an element of social proof. The more pictures showcasing a certain lifestyle is social proof as well. The more testimonials that you have are also some elements of social proof. Now, this will lead into the next thing, which is showing results. It's also some level of social proof, as I've said, but we're keeping this separate. The more proof that you can have that you actually generate results for other creators, and the more legitimate these testimonials look, the more real these testimonials look, the better it's going to be. So again, if you've got screenshots, for example, of results that you have for other creators, that's going to help. I know, again, I'm not saying this is something you should do, but of course you can get these screenshots from any profile if you really, really want to close a creator. But I'm not saying you should do this. I wouldn't say this is the best way to go about things. There should be actual results that you have. But if you maybe even just grow on a Reddit page, you can grow a Reddit page and have that as proof to showcase that you can get more results. Or you can just showcase another agency's results. Don't, of course, say it's another agency, but just say these sorts of results are possible via Reddit, via whatever method that you're going to be advertising for them in. So again, show those results. You can have those as a story highlighting your profile. You can have those as a linked website in your bio, if, for example, you're using Instagram. There's many ways to do that. You can have video testimonials that you send them, screenshots, whatever, but testimonials are going to build more trust. Then the third thing is provide contextual value, and I'll explain what that is, but that is basically using the law of reciprocity, which states that if you give somebody value, they're more inclined to give you back some value. In this case, if you give value to a prospective client, they're more likely want to work with you. It's the principle of reciprocity and it works across the board. So contextual value, and that is value based on what you can see in terms of the creator, things that they can improve on. So do these 3 things, they're going to trust you, you're going to get more results. So again, you may be trying to get results with a profile that looks like this. This profile is a blank profile, literally, not to throw this person under the bus. This person actually DM'd my Instagram. They say they're a video editing agency, yet if you look at the profile, it's completely blank. There's no social proof. They don't look like they've got tons of followers. There's no testimonial or portfolio on their profile. So again, it's not going to be likely that I actually respond to them. And if I respond to them, it's not likely I see them as a good agency for me to work with. So again, you want to stay clearly in your bio, what you do, who you help. You want to make sure that you have testimonials or some proof of a lifestyle that, for example, you will be able to attain for creators. Don't need to go overboard with it. Don't need to be on yachts or anything like that. But the more, the better. And just showcase what the creator may see as a creator on the other side may see as an agency actually capable of getting them results. And also, do not be sending out messages like this either. So, hey, are you interested in us to help manage you? This isn't a good message. This isn't giving the actual context of how you can help them, context of who you are. This is not a good message. So make sure you're not crafting messages like this and you don't have a profile that is like this. So if you do these things, it's never going to work. If you have a profile like this or a message like this, it's never going to work. So if it does, the difference will be between, for example, getting one response in 150 DMs that you send out during the week to having 10 responses in 150 DMs. Which one would you rather have? It's pretty obvious. So how can you build more social proof on your profile? I talked about this. One is follow account. You can go to a social media panel. I'll showcase some example. You can go there, buy followers very cheaply on the account. That's going to build up the social proof. Two, you can showcase a good life and showcase realness, just that you're a real person behind the profile. Again, it doesn't need to be yachts, as I said. Just need to showcase this is a real person. This looks like a trustworthy person. Again, it doesn't need to be posting beer bottles, doesn't need to be posting things like that. Showcase that this seems like somebody who you could think could actually help you. Number three, have a website showing other creators on there. It's very easy to do that, and I'll tell you exactly how you can do that. So to create a website, literally just go to buy a domain off Namecheap for $10. Easy. Number two, create a logo for free on canva.com. Three, create a site in 1 hour on card.co. and link your website in your bio or send it in your outreach message. Very simply, that is now getting some social proof in. It makes you look legitimate as an agency and it didn't take you that long. So just that $10, the free logo, is going to just make you stand out. Again, it's not necessary, but it's going to make sure that you just seem much more trustworthy to the other person on the other side of things. And who cares? The website doesn't need to actually say much. But again, it just puts you a step ahead of all those other agencies, in quotes, who are sending these outreach messages but just don't look legitimate. So you can just come into this site, SMM Panel or another similar site, come to see the Instagram services that they have, quickly just see how much they're selling per like. You can see the details inside here. It takes max 30 minutes to do this, and you can order max 10K likes at one go. Just come inside here, purchase, make the order, and then you get the likes to your page very quickly, and that builds up social proof. All right, so say we want to now find a name of your agency. Again, just brainstorm some names. Come to Namecheap. Let's say we're going to go with Lexus Classy Best Models. Now, that's an absolutely terrible name, but I'm just showing you, for the sake of this example, how to find a domain name. So we come inside here. And then you can see this is $8 a year, add to cart, and you just purchase that domain. Next, you can just come into Canva. Again, these are free logos that they have here. You can, for example, just pick one like this. We're going to customize this template. So for example, if we pick this one here, we can just type in Lexus Best Models or Model Agency. And then we can leave this like this. I know this is the wrong spelling, but now you've got your logo for your website. Very simply, you've got a domain name, you've got your logo, card.co. You just want to come here, choose a template that you want, whether it's just one that, it could literally just be this. It could be a plain one, but maybe something like this. Put your logo there, put a hero image, as well as a quick look at what you do as an agency. Select that, link it to your domain, and you've got your website just there. So in terms of how you can showcase results, obviously screenshots from past earning from creators, video testimonials if you have them, or just a look at what other agencies have been able to do. Again, as I said earlier on, don't say it's from another agency, just state that these are results that you can expect. And if you have that, that is definitely going to make sure your outreach is far more successful. Next, how to provide contextual value. That's the third thing in terms of building trust. So very easily, take a look at the creator's account and their current funnel. So if you found them on TikTok, take a look at what their profile is set up like, what sort of content they have on there. If you found them on Instagram, do the same thing. If you found them on Reddit, do the same thing. Also try and look at if you can find other sites that you have from them. If you found them on Instagram, again, still look for the Reddit, still look for the Twitter, etc., etc. See what you think could be done better and send that to her or him without asking for anything in return. So for example, say I came across this OF creator on Instagram here. This is the page I came across. I can see, again, it's a creator that is Currently Marketing. You can see all my links there. So she's got over 2,000 followers. So again, this is a prime prospect for me to want to reach out to. So I'm going to study the profile now. So I'm going to dive deep into the profile, and already off the bat, I noticed this. You're scrolling down on the profile, you notice one of her last posts was on 7 January. Today is, I'm making this video basically on the 1st of March. Then you can see the post before that was on 30th November. So there's literally 2 to 3 months before post on Instagram. So obviously you can already see off the bat, she could probably get better results if she's posting on Instagram once every couple of weeks instead, and had story posts to build that engagement with the people that are on her Instagram, leading to the link that she wants to direct people to, which is her All My Links. So that is something right off the bat I can suggest to her to provide that contextual value. Next, I click on the All My Links that she's got in the profile. What do you see here? There's tons of options that come up. So what you should know is, if you've got tons of options here, it's confusing for the end user. They don't know where to click to, so results are going to be lessened. So there's too many options essentially. So you want to direct people exactly where you want them to go, which will be the OnlyFans page. So in this case, there'll be better results if she had just two pages. For example, she wants people to be directed to, it could be TikTok, the OF page, and then maybe just one other link. It's far less complicated and far more likely to get people to actually click on it. And actually, you should put the OF link probably the first one there, because you want to direct people exactly where you want it to. Next, I go to the OF page. Couple things I see here. Again, last active on January 30th. Today is February 28th. So she's hardly posted on the page, is active, but not active enough. So again, she only has feed posts once every few weeks as well. You can see January 29th, January 13th. So even when she was active on the page, it's not enough engagement on there to be successful, to get the results that she may want to get. So in other words, you can see that there's a number of things she can improve very quickly on the account. So communicate that to the creator, and this will build trust. Finally, again, the last thing here is, think to yourself, as I've touched upon earlier in the video, how would you respond to this person coming on the other end of this thing? Would you respond to them? If that's a no, go back and implement based on these steps that I've outlined here. Think always, if you reach out to a creator and you were a creator, think always, if you were a creator and imagine yourself in the shoes of a creator, would you respond to yourself? Probably not. Probably you've got a profile that's not optimized, no social proof, you're not giving any contextual value. Fix these things and your outreach is going to do far better.